Hey guys, welcome back to my project. This is Eric. This project shows how to use the driver to communicate with USB HID devices such as keyboard and mouse on the ESP32-S2 and S3. Using a keyboard and mouse as input devices can be handy depending on the project. Let's say your application needs a lot of user input. These days, there are many products with built-in displays on the market, so you can use this to receive various inputs from the user like a smartphone by using a virtual keyboard. Also, as you know, ESP32-S2 and S3 support the native USB interface. It's very slow and outdated as USB 1.1, but it still makes a lot of things possible. For your information, the maximum speed is 12 Mbps. In today's video, I'm gonna build the USB HID class example released by ESPRESSIF and see how it works together. This is the system I put together. I'm using ESP32-S3 DevKit C1. It's a product that can be purchased very easily anywhere. The wrapped one is the USB breakout board. Data minus is connected to GPIO 19 and data plus is connected to GPIO 20. VCC is connected to 5 volts. After that, you can directly connect USB devices here. Finally, this is a ST7796 display with a resolution of 320 by 480. Used for this demo application. The design of the application used LVGL SqaureLine. How about this structure and wiring? I just made this for fun. Let's move on. First, this project has not yet been ported to the Arduino ESP32, so you have to use ESP-IDF. Currently, I'm using version 4.4.3 so far, so I will update to the latest version. Personally, I prefer to use Visual Studio Code. I think it's the best tool. The above one is version 4.4.3 and the bottom one is version 5.1. You can see that HID has been added to the USB host folder. The download and installation are done. Now let's load the USB HID class example. Keep scrolling down. You can find it from peripherals, USB, host, and select HID. Here you are, click the button. Finally, this is a newly added USB HID class example. This will allow you to connect a USB keyboard and mouse to your ESP32-S2 or S3. This example references the HID library, and this HID component references the USB library. This is my ESP32-S3 and USB breakout prepared for testing. As you can see, they are very simply connected. Everything is ready. Let me build it and see how it works. It was built without problems and flashed to the device. Let me connect my USB keyboard first. As soon as it is connected, my S3 detects it. The connection has been successful. Now let me type something. The response is very fast. There is no problem at all, and simultaneous input of multiple keys is possible. If you hold down the shift key while typing, uppercase letters are the output. However, it seems that other function keys have not been implemented yet. Currently, only numbers and alphabets can be entered. Looking at the keyboard report description below, it seems that it can recognize 6 keys at once, but as a result of my testing, only 5 keys were recognized at a time. When 6 or more keys are input at the same time, a wrapped mouse click event occurs. I don't know why. I guess this needs more testing. This time, I will remove the keyboard from the device and switch to the mouse. This is Logitech MX Master 2S wireless mouse, so there is a unifying receiver. Let me connect this. It says device won't gone as soon as remove the keyboard. It seems connected. I'm going to move my mouse. There was a bit of a delay when I first moved, but immediately the delay was gone. It's also very responsive. It goes X minus on the wrapped X plus on the right, Y minus on the top, Y plus on the bottom. I forgot to test left click and right click when shooting this video. They all work well, so don't worry. I tried to connect the keyboard and mouse at the same time using USB hub, but I failed. I think it's definitely possible. I'm trying to do a project that utilizes the keyboard and mouse at the same time. I'll try again later. This is my favorite UI editor, SqaureLine Studio. You can easily create a very nice UI with this. After creating UI, you can export it as code and put those files into your project. For more details, please refer to the SqaureLine tutorial on my channel. Unfortunately, this application is not yet completed. Because there are some keyboard events that are not implemented in the example, they don't work fully yet. You can even enter new lines and spaces, but it's okay. It's great to be able to use a USB keyboard and mouse as input devices on ESP32-S2 and S3. I think this also provides an opportunity to do a variety of projects. That's the point. I will do my best to do a project using this and try to open it as soon as possible. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.